Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is Monday, October 8th, 2012. I'm Alex Jones, your host. Thank you so much for joining us here today. We'll be here for the next 3 hours. And wow, is there a lot of news and information to cover. We are going to open the phones up throughout the 3 hours today. And when we come back in the next break, I'm going to give the phone number out for first-time callers in the first hour into the second hour. Then we'll have a total free-for-all after that. I'll do my best job racing to your calls and going through them as quickly as I can. Where to begin? Former Secretary of Defense Gates was quoted last week, CBS News, saying a military strike against Iran would be catastrophic. The current head of the CIA, Panetta, warns conflict between Syria and Turkey may produce regional war. Or Defense Secretary Leon Panetta, I always get that mixed up with CIA, pretty much the same thing, said on Saturday that the conflict on the border between Syria and Turkey may spread to the neighboring countries and create a regional war. So there you have it. Meanwhile, a think tank, path to Iran nuke warhead, 2 to 4 months. That's the Associated Press. So the hype is out there. You've got think tanks on C-SPAN, the Near East Group Center and others openly saying we need a false flag to go into Iran. In fact, cue that up, guys. I know I said Friday cue it up, never went to it, but I'm going to go to that coming up the next segment because it's so important. All of this is unfolding before our very eyes, and Obama, NATO, the globalist, with Turkey, have been inserting tens of thousands of al-Qaeda and other jihadis into Syria to engage in just incredibly immoral preemptive invasion proxy war. And now the UN and NATO have had to admit, and Turkey's had to admit, okay, we don't have proof that Syria fired some mortars. And we did basically make it up that they had apologized for it. So there's your false flag right there. And even Panetta is saying, again, as I just read, that this could lead to a much, much wider war that could lead to a new world war. But this is a war going on, a large war going on. And it ties into the world economic meltdown that's happening. It ties into the martial law preparations, troops more and more on the streets running crowd control in the United States, just a phase into martial law, unannounced martial law. All of this is happening. And they're trying to bring back the Model States Health Emergency Powers Act for forced inoculations. I'm going to get back into that news that I covered some of yesterday, but a lot more is out on that now. And then, of course, TSA and the police are rolling out at checkpoints body scanners that, quote, know everything about your body. DrudgeReport.com, link to our story on Friday throughout the weekend by Lisa Garber up at Infowars.com. But I want to go over some of this because these are just quack machines, just like they hook you up to a lie detector and say, oh, it says you're a terrorist, and it turns out it's a fraud. Or crime labs have been caught framing people in every major city that you can imagine. Dallas, Houston, just where I live in Texas, and New York, the FBI crime lab's famous, the San Francisco crime lab, industrial scale frame-ups. Well, now they just have a computer. Well, it says you have explosives. It says you smoke marijuana. It says you're a drug addict. Goodbye, no judge, no jury, the computer says. So it's just a complete overthrow of our liberty and freedom. That's all coming up. Romney's vowing to arm al-Qaeda terrorists in Syria. So him and Obama are battling out to see who can be the most warmongering. Just a completely immoral on its face. But because the public is so ignorant on basic facts, it's just a non-issue. So we're going to be breaking all of this down and a lot more, and your phone calls, big broadcast lined up today. Thank you for joining us. It is is Monday, the 8th day of October 2012. Thank you so much for joining us today. We're going to have wide open phones throughout the 3 hours, interspersed with masses of vital news and information. I spent about 10 minutes yesterday on this, but didn't go through but a fraction of the articles I have on it. There are reports all over the United States in newspapers saying that there are no side effects from the flu vaccine, the seasonal flu vaccine. So I thought I would read from the CDC the side effects from the seasonal flu vaccine. You can also just type into a search engine, insert for seasonal flu vaccine 2012. And epilepsy, narcolepsy, Guillain-Barre, there's hundreds of them. So we'll be going over those and then reading from stories like the News Journal out of Texas saying there is absolutely no harm from getting a vaccination. That's a quote. Don't let yourself be fooled by wild rumors. So we're going to be going over that at the bottom of the next hour. I'm going to do a whole report on that. The facts versus the wild rumors. You know, I love the, quote, mainstream media, the dinosaur skeleton. I mean, it's a skeleton of what it once was. Always sitting up there just saying, oh, rumors, conspiracy theorists. They've got these one-liner terms. Oh, kooks, crazy people. Oh, really? Well, we're going to go over the facts here. The Canadian government study saying it doubles your chances of getting the flu to take the flu shot. Merck and their MMR shot giving you MMR. I mean, we've got it all right here. And we're going to be breaking it down for you. We also have a new article up at Infowars.com and PrismaWanda.com. American undergraduates recruited for population control agenda as UN raises the stakes. Yeah, UN operatives under foundation funding. That's the big robber baron groups that are tax-free. Their profits are tax-free to carry out these operations of engineering society. They are totally shifting the American system and coming in with unlimited money and tax incentives to hand over control of every facet of our lives. And I was talking to my dad this weekend. He was talking to a major health company executive. And the fellow was telling my dad, it's one of my dad's friends for years, wow, you know, you're absolutely right. And, you know, this stuff's really happening. I was sent to this, you know, Harvard Executive Business School for a few months. And they just told us, you know, the world government is here. It's going to be run by foundations. They are going to take over the role of government. And they're going to be called stakeholders. And it's Agenda 21. I mean, that's it. But you don't need to go to some Harvard, you know, executive school. Of course, they're there telling you this is the way of the future. This is how you're going to be able to even have a job in the future. You better just submit to the New World Order. And again, they have their operatives in all the government regulatory positions. They're going to be allowed to operate and do business. You and I are not. And they're going to use regulations to bankrupt everybody. Take France. They've got close to a 90% tax rate. On, quote, the wealthy, unless you're the ultra-rich, they're then exempt with loopholes and enforcement. And then the nouveau riche French are able to, you know, flee the country, but not for long because it's a new world order. Global government is all about not being able to flee. But the nouveau riche are trying to flee. Got articles today where they're selling their property, selling their holdings and getting out. But if you look at what's happening now, France is trying to erect currency and capital controls where you can. Same things are being erected here in the United States. That's why so many extremely wealthy people, including members of John Wayne's family and others, were escaping in the last 3 years. They were saying, you've got to get out by 2012, then the rules change. So it's all happening right now. A global corporate tyranny is coming in and shutting down freedom. And it's in all the financial publications. It's all being announced. Meanwhile, though, the average police officer has been given manuals saying if somebody talks about global corporate government, they're a terrorist that wants to kill you. This doesn't exist. And the average cop is just like the general public, dumber than a box of rocks, dumbed down. And I've got articles here today in my stack where people that play terrorists in TV shows are being attacked, are being confronted, because the public doesn't know the difference. And studies have shown that, that when people watch shows like 24, then, of course, that show's no longer on, well, they don't have new episodes, but it's in syndication, or when they watch all the dozens of other shows, every cop show, every military show out there, you torture people. Good guys torture. Good guys break rules. Good guys kill innocent people. Good guys torture children. And people are watching this fantasizing. In fact, here's that article, then I'll get into the other news. Damian Lewis feared he was going to get his head pulverized after he was confronted over his terrorist role in Homeland. These are the type of shows they have. And they have shows now where it's based in Texas. And you're a terrorist, basically, if you're pro-gun. Homeland star Damian Lewis has revealed how he feared he was going to get beaten up for playing a terrorist. The Emmy-winning actor said he was confronted by an angry American while filming the series where he plays a Marine who's been turned by a terrorist group. He said his portrayal of the traitor was so convincing that people actually believed he was real. And again, who are the terrorists in Homeland? The confrontation came as he filmed Homeland in Charlotte, North Carolina, he told Knoxville.com. There was a slightly hairy moment down in Charlotte. There was a barbecue going on, and there was a bunch of Southern boys there drinking beer, eating fried chicken, eating steak. One of them comes up to me and says, "So you're playing a terrorist?" A nervous Lewis said, "Yes, I actually don't know yet." He looked me in the eye, slightly drunk, blurry-eyed, I thought. I was about to get my head pulverized. I'm going to bleep off a lot of people. And then he goes into basically the guy threatening him. Lewis joked that when he first met Obama, he asked him if he could let him know when the U.S. planned to attack Iran so he could use it in his second series of Homeland. And these are all these shows coming out. They've got a new one on NBC called Founding Fathers coming out, where an army commando infiltrates a group of right-wingers who don't want to turn their guns in and are terrorists. And the cops are all watching this, thinking that if you actually are a real American and understand what's happening, you're a terrorist. And then they fantasize. It all blurs together. What Hasselhoff has talked about, people constantly coming up to him thinking Baywatch was real and that he was really a lifeguard there. You know, the actors involved in Fantasy Island talked about how constantly they were being approached about, where is Fantasy Island? We want to go there. I read articles about people thought Gilligan's Island was real and being filmed there. You see, the general public, and this is the key to everything, is in a suspended disbelief. That's when you go to a movie, and within minutes, the average person clicks off and just accepts it as real. That's why movies and things really aren't entertaining to me anymore, because I don't ever really suspend my disbelief. I'm sitting there thinking about the lighting and the wardrobe and the acting. And a couple of weeks ago, Billy Corgan, Smashing Pumpkins founder, was here in Austin. We went out to dinner. And we went to a steakhouse, and they played pretty good jazz in there. I mean, I like it. And it was Eddie V's. And I said, "Hey, you want to go listen, you know, in the lounge, or you want to go eat in here, in the main diner?" And he goes, no, the lounge. He goes, "It sounds good, but I'll be at work the whole time thinking about what they're doing and what they're playing. I want to be as far away from the music as possible," because he had to play at Stubbs the next night. And it's the same thing. I'm sitting there watching this. I mean, it's in the news that all these shows are paid by Homeland Security, billions of dollars a year total. I mean, you saw it in the news 2 weeks ago where hundreds of millions is being spent of the huge, some years $10 billion budget of government to pay to have propaganda placement, what they call behavior placement, into the shows promoting Obamacare. I mean, we're not in Kansas anymore. That's not what a free country does. This really got big under Clinton. Bush expanded it, and now Obama has exploded it. In fact, the last number I saw, well, Congress ruled and said it, you know, it's illegal. The Congressional Budget Office, the General Accounting Office, they all looked at it and said, this has got to stop. And last time I checked, it was $10 billion a year. Now, there it is. Homeland Security films are a big hit, but costly. And again, that's the Austin Chronicle. That's the Houston Chronicle they pulled up. I don't know if that's the particular article pertaining to that, but you can type in Obamacare to be promoted in TV shows, and that'll pull that up for people. The point is, that's like North Korea. That's like Nazi Germany, when the state is there with messages, and the public literally goes and accepts it all like it's real. And so that's why we're in this position as a society. That's why when a cop pulls you over and you've got a Ron Paul sticker or Get Us Out of the UN sticker, their training manuals are backed up by countless cop shows where murderers, killers, child killers, child torturers, people that are going to launch bio attacks on New York, every show out there that we go and look at the script of, every show my wife sometimes, you know, downloads different TV shows, she says every medical show demonizes people that don't like abortions, is pro-forced vaccination, anti-family. You know, all the women dramas. They're literally assaulting everyone, and the general public have their imaginary friends on television that are their little buddies, and they're living this fantasy. So when a cop pulls you over, folks, they think they've pulled a terrorist over because you actually follow the Bill of Rights and Constitution. To be a real American is to be a terrorist. Ladies and gentlemen, I have absolutely immersed myself in the globalist system. I have immersed myself in researching their white papers, their statements, their goals. And it is a private global corporate government that is scientific based but predatory, that is seeking after super weapons, life extension technologies, and who sees the general world population as garbage to be taken out, to be reduced down to nothing. And I know I am right about my overall analysis and breakdown of the globalist. Do I occasionally make mistakes? Sure. Yesterday I was talking about an article with a bill in the House of Representatives, and the article was written by Paul Watson. I misread it that it had passed the House. It's in committee, dealing with preparations for mass casualties. But the point is, the article was about the preparations for mass casualties by FEMA, confirming what Aaron Dykes and I and others broke at Infowars.com 3.5 years ago. But I will make that correction here. It's not past the House. Or Panetta was the head of the CIA, now Secretary of Defense. So earlier I called him head of the CIA, not Secretary of Defense. Little things like that. But the overall general points we make are incontrovertible. There are multiple congressmen, there are multiple movie stars, Miss USA, the list goes on and on, and videos of TSA grabbing people's genitals, men's testicles, and crushing them as punishment. Congressman out of San Antonio just a few months ago talked about that. Brushed the guy's hand away as he crushed him. And they said, hey, we're going to charge you with assault for not letting us assault you. TSA agents have pled guilty and admitted they rob people that don't let them grope them or complain. And now the new article is out at Infowars.com. TSA workers smacked me in my testicles for refusing body scan. Federal screeners now crushing genitals as form of punishment. Well, yeah, who else wants this type of job? We're in a very, very dark time. And people who look back on history, you know, they say, how did the Germans do it? How did the Russians do it? How did the Romans put up with it? How did the Babylonians put up with it? How did the ancient Chinese put up with it? Well, most of the time it was fashion. They said it's fashionable to sacrifice your one-year-old child on an altar. Most cultures said, oh, well, the Druids, the Europeans, they thought it was cool to cut their children up in pieces and eat them. The Aztecs and the Mayans thought it was cool to cut their kids up and eat them. Again, because it was the fashion, it was the religion, it was the style. Japanese wealthy women, Chinese wealthy women would have their feet bound where they couldn't even walk, because when you're really rich, you can't walk. You have to be carried around. That was actually the servant caste manipulating with propaganda the rulers into becoming prisoners. And that's how we're going into bondage, is fads and styles. It's very stylish to get into being scared of al-Qaeda, who the government publicly runs. It's very stylish to get into having no rights and being jellyfish-like. Men are now taught, the more, not even effeminate, but the more weak they are, the more passé, the more passive, the more pathetic they are, the cooler they are. TSA workers smacked me in my testicles for refusing body scan. Federal screeners now crushing genitals as form of punishment. Yeah, it's torture. And then Watson has all these links to mainstream news, not just this latest case, where people complain so they crush their genitals, illustrating once again how the TSA is handing out arbitrary punishments for people who exercise their right to opt out of radiation firing body scanners. Frequent flyer Stephen DeFrost described how he had his testicles smacked by a TSA screener for refusing to go through the scanner. While traveling through Las Vegas, oh yeah, I've been through there, DeFrost chose to opt out of the naked body scanner and was told to wait in a glass holding box. A bulky young TSA agent came over to pat me down, DeFrost told author Christopher Elliott. He told me to turn around. He was using his command voice, barking orders. I told him that I wasn't comfortable turning away from my luggage. Well, yeah, because TSA is known to rob you, which has already been screened, and wanted to keep it in sight. The agent issued more orders. Stay here. I didn't tell you to move, and empty your pockets. And DeForest says the federal screener seemed irritated that he didn't obey without hesitation. And that's when DeForest says he was punished. The agent knelt in front of him to conduct the pat down. As he raised his hands, he was looking at me, he says. Then he gave me a quick flick and smacked me in one of my testicles. Well, that's what you get. I mean, that's a freedom. In fact, the new American flag should be testicles with a hammer smashing them flat. I mean, that is freedom. That is freedom. Yeah, I'm public enemy number one. If you think public opinion that supports world government is a good idea, what we have is manufactured public opinion more and more in this country. And even when, 90%+, as the polls in Rhode Island showed, of the nurses and doctors didn't want to be forced to take flu shots, and their unions didn't want it, it's now, quote, the law that they take the shots. But really, you read it, it's the law that it's mandated regulatorily, but that they still can't force you to do it. That's coming up later in the next hour. You know, I said I'd go to your phone calls. I want to get into some military and economic news, and then we will. First-time callers, we'd love to hear from you. Give new callers a chance to join us here on air. The toll-free number is 1-800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. And I know John Harmon may have already sent it. If you haven't, John, send it over. I know we've got like 7 or 8 new affiliates just signed up in the last week that are now starting today. I'd like to be able to plug all those fine AM and FM stations. We're now over 120 stations and growing. The show is just exploding by the grace of God, and I am very honored to be your host and humbled. Okay. Wow, where to start here on the whole military front? Let me just start here. This is CBS News. Gates, military strike against Iran would be catastrophic. Former Secretary of State Robert Gates warns a military strike on Iran would be catastrophic. Gates made the comment before the Union University 15th Annual Scholarship Banquet. The results of an American or Israeli military strike on Iran could, in my view, prove catastrophic. Haunting us for generations in that part of the world, Gates said, according to the Virginia Pilot. There's video of it. Okay, so there's that. Here is another one, Kurt Nemo, but he links through to the Associated Press. Panetta warns conflict between Syria and Turkey may produce regional war. Defense Secretary Leon Panetta said on Saturday that the conflict on the border between Syria and Turkey may spread to neighboring countries and create a regional war. What have I been saying for months is happening? They're trying to get a Shiite-Sunni civil war going. And to have the defense secretary, who was the head of the CIA, Leon Panetta, come out and act like that they're not part of this, just like we had Dempsey come out a month ago, he's the chairman, Joint Chiefs of Staff, and say, hey, if Israel attacks, we're not involved with what happens. That's balderdash. NATO is run by the globalist. The United States is run by the globalist. Our military has been told they're under NATO command. When our troops die, the newspaper says NATO troops now. NATO, in the UN's own words, is the global government army. Just type in NATO is the global government army. You'll get Herman Von Rompuy, Barroso, the heads of the EU. I just got chills. Man, it's all coming down. It's so insane. I was just reading where they're now implementing the New Freedom Initiative that started 5 years ago nationwide in the government training camps and the private schools that are, quote, accredited. They're taking the 5 and 6 year olds and putting them through psychological screening written by Big Pharma to put 50% of kids on drugs. They got 20% in their own documents. WorldNet Daily got them. Pennsylvania head of the program went public, I don't know, 5, 6 years ago. You can pull these up and said the plan is to drug half the kids. They had 20% on psychotropics then. They're just going to say half the kids are mentally ill and put them on deadly drugs. And then Rob Dew was just showing me mainstream articles about it today, where now they want to come to homeschoolers' houses, even if you try to escape them. The government cult comes. And then if you don't trust the government cult, that's signs of mental illness. And then the SWAT team comes. I mean, it's now coming to the armed men are coming to give your children to the psychiatry cult run by Big Pharma that's founded by eugenicists. I mean, just 100 years ago, they were doing public in a traveling road show, the U.S. Psychology Association, Psychiatry Association, where they would do at county fairs. They would with ice picks. You can, if you don't believe me, look this up, quote, mentally ill people, and everybody would gather around, and they would jab an ice pick through the temple into the brain and just start stabbing the brain of local, generally Down syndrome children and others who'd grown up and were a little boisterous and couldn't be controlled. They'd just ice pick them. Guys, type in psychiatrist performing public lobotomy, and there'll be photos of psychiatry students around it being done, but also traveling buses into the 40s doing it. I mean, again, it's just the hell level of all this, the hell force, and people will just not believe it's happening. You're going to see people get more and more angry at us, folks, more and more upset as millions wake up every week, and as the show explodes, and as it goes into overdrive. And as I face whatever fate I face is my punishment from the globalist. Doesn't matter. It's absolute destiny that I do this. You're going to see those that wake up and become enlightened and absolutely tear away the trance they're in and just see the nightmare we're in. And you're going to have those that become absolutely angry, even those that we've thought have been awake, friends and family, you know, as the horror of reality gets so real. And in their face, they are going to embrace the darkness instead of the light. And it's just we're going to see insane times. Our children turned over to psychiatry. Checkpoints on the highways run by regular Army and Marines. Now in the news everywhere. No longer are they drills. Told you that was coming. You're going to see just the breakdown of society and the family. You're going to see major cities where the police pull back. And don't even provide, you're going to see it in Oakland. They've already announced 35 crimes, including felonies, armed robbery that they won't respond to. They've now put up public notices in Detroit not to enter it. And if you do it, your own risk. The police will now only do revenue generation for themselves. Hundreds of sheriff's departments, hundreds, are announcing at least 50% cuts. And those that they keep will be revenue generation. This is the designed collapse. This is designed barbarism. You see, this is the opposite of the Enlightenment or the Renaissance. This is the reversal of society. This is the destruction of humanity. This is the post-industrial world. This is the new dark age. This is the Hunger Games model, where that's what Agenda 21 is, where we live in rural areas and are under calorie control, and when we go above a certain calorie level, we're going to be put into forced labor camps. That's why the Defense Department's putting cameras in lunchrooms from Florida to Texas, scanning the children, and reports are being made. Children will also be taken if they're 1 pound overweight. All of that has been announced. This is the total phase-in of just hell. TSA is now operating checkpoints on highways all over the place. They are now crushing testicles of those that don't submit to them, robbing bags of those that don't submit to them as punishment. It is just, and again, the average person who's accepted all this, they hear me reporting on what's admitted, and I'm bad for reporting it. Now, again, the Secretary of Defense has said an Iran attack will be horrible. The last SecDef has said it will be a catastrophe that could lead to a new world war. Most think tanks say that. Most analysts, military and historical analysts, say that. But the bankers don't care. They know they're about to ride that dragon, ride that tiger. They bring in a big enough global crisis, a big enough global meltdown, a big enough global catastrophe. They're going to be able to then pose as the saviors. Just as they've implemented the derivatives worldwide crash, the black hole, impossible to pay back, and signed us onto it, and then have the prostitute media tell the public it's our debt when it's not our debt. They know what they're doing. One country called their bluff, Iceland, and found out 90%+ of the debt was the bankers and not theirs, and arrested the head bankers, who it turned out were foreign banking agents. This is a new kind of war. This is a corporate carpetbagger style takeover. This is economic warfare. Carpetbagger 2.0 worldwide. And it's here. And it's real. And it's going to get insane. As long as we don't have a mass awakening that the bad guys are the ones imploding things to reorganize and re-engineer and re-educate, just as the communists run by the bankers did in the Soviet Union and did in communist China. They want to implode things first. That was declassified from the Red Terror under Lenin. That was released by the Russians. In the last few decades, they've been releasing all that, where it was admitted that they wanted to shut down production. They wanted to starve people. They wanted to cut the power off. They wanted to shut everything off. They know what they're doing. They've got to destroy us. They've got to bring us down. And what I feel sorry for is the idiots that serve the system. Folks, they're not bad people, most of them. They're idiots. They're drawn from the general public that literally has never opened a history book and has no idea what we're staring at right now. So, Panetta warns conflict between Syria and Turkey may produce regional war. And then in the video clip, he goes on to say it is a war already. No kidding. New York Times concedes that it is unknown whether Syrian artillery came from rebels or government. And Turkey's still shelling them. And has passed this declaration of war, basically. They don't call it that, so it's not a war. AP reports think tank path to Iran nuke warhead 2 to 4 months. So, again, the word is they're either going to hit them in late October, early November, or they're going to wait and hit whenever the new president, whether it's the old president or Romney, in February. And you can just type in war set for next spring or late winter. I don't know. And they may not do it then. There may be cooler heads prevail. But they don't have the chairman of the Joint Chiefs saying this is a bad idea, and the Secretary of Defense and the last Secretary of Defense saying it's a bad idea, and could be a catastrophe. What did Ron Paul say 2 weeks ago about QE Unlimited? He said, you should be panicking. Ron Paul is absolutely right. Cue up that Ron Paul, you should be panicking after I play this. I'm going to go to your call, Sean, Harold, Josh, Robert, Nick, everybody, but this has got to be covered. We now have Mitt Romney. The story is up at Infowars.com. And I just had it here in front of me, and I've got so many articles, I now can't find it. Here it is. Romney vows to arm al-Qaeda terrorists in Syria. And again, you've got the neocons saying Obama didn't handle this al-Qaeda attack in Libya properly. You know, he should have had more security. NATO runs al-Qaeda and put them in the country. I mean, that's admitted. So none of them are even having a real debate. And now Romney has come out and is set to give a speech tonight, but they've already released details of it, saying we need to back the valiant rebels that are attacking Syria. I mean, this is so immoral. I have never seen a time in history where the public was so dumbed down that an elite would simultaneously say, we've got to take all your rights and liberties because al-Qaeda is going to attack you at the airport or on the highway, and that the Tea Party works with al-Qaeda. That's in the new Army manual. I mean, just ridiculous. And that simultaneously they run al-Qaeda. I mean, real al-Qaeda. We have the videos up there and news articles over the weekend. Headline, you know, rebel leader, al-Qaeda flag, we will not stop until al-Qaeda flag flies over White House. Well, I mean, it already does. The globalists run al-Qaeda. Romney vows to arm al-Qaeda terrorists in Syria, Infowars.com. Mitt Romney will vow to arm Syrian rebels today during a major foreign policy speech, illustrating once again how there is virtually no difference between Romney and Obama when it comes to serving the interest of military-industrial complex. And he's saying there aren't enough troops on the ground. They've got U.S. advisors literally advising guys with al-Qaeda uniforms on and al-Qaeda flags. That's in BBC, Reuters, you name it, L.A. Times. I mean, again, this is all so off the charts. Let's go ahead and go to this video clip. It's up at Infowars.com. We covered it last week. Breaking. Lobbyist. We need a false flag to start war with Iran. Patrick Clausen of the influential neocon Washington Institute for Near East Studies openly suggests the U.S. should provoke Iran into taking the first shot. Now, what did Cheney want to do? Paint up a U.S. boat like an Iranian boat, have Navy SEALs attack. But the head of CENTCOM, Admiral Fallon, Fox Fallon said no and resigned. This would have already happened, ladies and gentlemen. And again, it will be bad for everybody. $7, $8, $9, $10 a barrel of gas or a gallon of gas, you know, $200, $300 a barrel of crude oil. But the globalists want to get this going. Here is the clip on C-SPAN. They posted this on their own website, too. Go watch the whole speech. It's incredible. It's an hour long. Here it is. Here they are thinking, you're so stupid. They're talking about false flags on TV. Here it is.
I frankly think that crisis initiation is really tough. And it's very hard for me to see how the United States president can get us to war with Iran. Which leads me to conclude that if, in fact, compromise is not coming, that the traditional way of America gets to war is what would be best for U.S. interests. Some people might think that Mr. Roosevelt wanted to get us into World War II, as David mentioned. You may recall we had to wait for Pearl Harbor. Some people might think Mr. Wilson wanted to get us into World War I. You may recall he had to wait for the Lusitania episode. Some people might think that Mr. Johnson wanted to send troops to Vietnam. You may recall he had to wait for the Gulf of Tonkin episode. We didn't go to war with Spain until the USS, until the Maine exploded. And may I point out that Mr. Lincoln did not feel he could call out the Federal Army until Fort Sumter was attacked, which is why he ordered the commander at Fort Sumter to do exactly that thing which the South Carolinians had said would cause an attack. So if, in fact, the Iranians aren't going to compromise, it would be best if somebody else started the war. One can combine other means of pressure with sanctions. I mentioned that explosion on August 17th. We could step up the pressure. I mean, look, people, Iranian submarines periodically go down. Someday one of them might not come up. Who would know why? We can do a variety of things if we wish to increase the pressure. I'm not advocating that. But I'm just suggesting that this is not a either-or proposition. It's just sanctions has to succeed or other things. We are in the game of using covert means against the Iranians.
Yeah.
We could get nastier at that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, like 9/11? Like PNAC wrote in September 20, 2000, a new Pearl Harbor event, a catastrophic terror attack killing 3,000? They actually said 3,000. Boy, they know what they're doing. Oh, yeah. We're not in Kansas anymore, ladies and gentlemen. There is unlimited evil taking place right now. Does that mean the Iranians are good? No. The Iranian government? No. But this is what's happening, and the bankers want this world war to bring in their world government. as they've said they're going to use the crisis to bring in world government. The banking crisis alone. Your calls are straight ahead. Stay with us. If you study history, you know tyranny gets absolutely crazy because once people start doing whatever they're told, the very worst will end up getting in control, and so all their crazy desires get turned loose. Okay, give me your firstborn to sacrifice. Okay, let's go attack our neighbors for no reason. Okay, you have to worship me as a god. I mean, that's what ends up happening. And we have crazy government out of control. Where TSA, in Paul Watson's article, he has links to it. You know, congressmen talking about it, you name it. They are abused and have their testicles crushed as punishment. And women have their breasts grabbed, and then they have to settle. They even tell them, oh, you're good looking, baby. Can I have your number? When they're grabbing their breast in front of everybody. Those are the cases where you don't go to the private rape room. So I'm going to be going over that more later, too. I mean, it's just scores of examples where they now torture us. You're like, well, that couldn't be true. That's too over the top. It is true because we put up with it. The limit is what we put up with, and we will put up with anything now in this country. I go all over the place now, and I watch police, and so many of them like walk around bugging their eyes out at people. And I'm just like, well, what is this for? And it's all the government is here to let us know, hey, you work for us, and I'm tired of it, and I don't like it. And I got a big stack of news here. I said I'd go to your calls. Let's just go to your calls. Harold and then Sean and Josh and Robert and Nick and many others. Harold in Idaho, thanks for holding. You're on the air, sir. Welcome.
Yes, sir. My first-time caller, Alex, Harold Jones. And I caught your item on the veterans getting shots, you know, being inoculated with disease through shots. That happened to me. I went to the VA to get a pain shot for my back. And my wife and I got home, and within the three-hour drive from there, from Mullen to Spokane, the VA hospital, my right side of my back started tightening up. I woke up the next morning all swollen up, bleeding. I went to a non-VA doctor and had a scope done, and they diagnosed me with Crohn's disease. I never had it before.
Yeah, well, in the CDC's admissions, they say bowel disorders, which is Crohn's and other things that the shots are giving people, causes autoimmune response in the gut. There's tons of studies on that. But the VA is the worst medical system in the world. They've hired thousands of doctors with foreign degrees that aren't even really doctors. And they're there to spy on you on average. There are some good doctors still. They're there to get you into the system and diagnose you with PTSD. But, I mean, the VA has done hundreds and hundreds of the thousands of admitted lethal tests on veterans and active duty. So why would any troops be surprised when our so-called government has made a practice for more than 70 years of killing our troops in secret experiments? Again, the people running things want to murder you and your family. And they're there just trying to show us TV shows about torture and stuff to get us all to accept it. And the minute they get everybody to accept it, it's over. Katie, bar the door. Re-education camps are set up. The gun confiscation plans are ready. They're going to try to have a Soviet-style takeover here in America. It's going to be a total civil war, and I wouldn't want to be the enforcers that try to pull this off. Because they may have mind control over most people, but they don't have mind control over a lot of us. Anything else, sir?
Yes, sir. Well, we're not that far from Hardin, Montana here, the camp that you had on the video. Now, here in Mullen, I'm sure the video's been there. That Mullen mayor and his girlfriend were trying to recall the mayor here. Well, now they can't afford to keep the ambulance service. They're trying to split some phony clinic in this town, gets a foothold, and they're getting government grants and things to finance.
Yeah, no. Listen, the local VA-run clinics are spy bases against the veterans. The veterans are the number one enemy in the New World Order. That's official FBI training manuals. You are the enemy. Understand it. The bankers want you dead. Coming up, a new global war is not coming. It's already started. We're going to be breaking some of that down. Also, the globalists are coming in and starting forced psychological testing of your children. We're going to be breaking all of that down. TSA workers now torturing people to, quote, punish them and robbing them. This is all admitted. That's up at Infowars.com. Let's go to your phone calls, though, right now. Let's go ahead and talk to Nick and then Sean and others. Nick in the great state of Texas, welcome.
Yes, hello, Alex. I've followed you for quite a while. I've been studying a lot of stuff since I was about 15. Anyway, active duty military, I wanted to talk just briefly about what has happened to me as a result of everything that's happened throughout my life. You know, long story, but short story for the problem. Been in the service for about 4 years now. Now I'm getting ready to medically retire. I was a person who had no health problems whatsoever before that.
Oh, yeah, they've got to retire a piece of military equipment. You spike a cannon, they cut up guns after they're done with them. They got to get rid of you. DU, all the experimental vaccines. You know where the medical companies now go other than foster children that they grab? That's on record, New York Daily News and other reports. You know where they get their guinea pigs to get drugs approved and vaccines? They do human testing on the troops, which is illegal. Yeah, but the troops think, oh, you can do whatever you want to me. Really, can they murder you? No. They can only give you vaccines that have been fully approved and aren't experimental. But they shoot the troops up with soft kill weapons that are meant to debilitate you down the road.
This when they did this to me, they injected me with the virus, and I was down in a weekend, hospitalized for 3 months, and they pretty much told, because each soldier has over $1 million on their head of life insurance. So they asked the parents, well, do you want to keep them alive or kill them? They actually asked my mother that. And she said, no, I want you to save them.
Hey, I had one of Rick Perry's employees come to Endgame premiere 6 years ago. I'd seen the guy on the news. He even gave me his card, but then would never come on the show. And he's like, well, I want you to know, I was a medic at Fort Sam Houston Medical Center in San Antonio. And, you know, a few years ago, before I worked for Rick Perry, before I got out of the service, I think he said like 10 years before, they brought in special forces, injected them, and they died. And then it was our job to scrub everything out. So I know about the medical experiments, and so does the governor. And he wants you to know that he's a good guy. And I was like, well, then why did he just say Gardasil's the law? You got to take it. Well, just Rick Perry's a good guy. And I knew that he was in this movie, so I came to see it. One of his communications people. And I mean, it's like a Rick Perry's guy sitting there telling you, oh, yeah, they brought the special forces in. They were shot up, and then they all died, and that's just what we do in America. And I was like, what is the point of this meeting? I mean, and it's just like, oh, they're just dead. You know, the government loves you, though. Anything else?
It's crazy because it's these type of people, you know, I mean, they'll kill you and then blame you for it. That was your fault that this happened to you.
Well, sir, I mean, just and I appreciate your call. God bless you. It's beyond evil. I mean, you know, in all the major studies of the GMO corn, the GMO wheat, the soybeans, the canola, all of it, automatic organ failure, automatic early death, automatic mutations within three generations, and a bunch of studies, 99% sterilization, hair growing out of the mouth, tiny genitals on the guinea pigs and rats, the females, just unbelievable cancer in the reproductive organs. Just rats dragging huge tumors around. I mean, it's just, we're getting soft killed right now. I mean, I don't know what I'm supposed to say at this point. We're going to go to break and come back with more calls. I mean, it's just, they're killing us. I'm just here going, wow, this is really horrible. And the average minion of the system's watching fantasy shows where, you know, the security services torture everybody and society collapses and the good guys rip people's teeth out with pliers and torture children. And then meanwhile, the Army's own reports admit that's what goes on. I mean, it's just absolute mass Satanism taking over. And I don't know what to say. They're getting ready to start a giant world war, and they're imploding the world economies and accelerating inflation. I mean, it's unbelievable. Tuning in for the first time, thank you for joining us. If you're tuning in for the 500th time, thank you for joining us. I'm just a regular guy who studied history, and I don't want to repeat what I've seen happen to every other civilization, where you let corrupt madmen and corrupt groups of people get into power who have very, very wicked fantasies. And when we lay down to them, it allows them to basically carry out those bizarre fantasies of war and death and domination upon us. And we are now entering one of those phases that you saw before World War I or World War II. We're now entering one of those times of great calamity. For many people around the world, 30 million folks starve to death a year, half of them children. The UN is seeking to turn off energy development and food supplies to those countries. The UN is financing wars. It's a State Department Memorandum 200 to artificially destroy the crops. It is just a very predatory global government system that we're facing. And I want to go back to your phone calls now here in this hour. And then we'll get more into the former Secretary of Defense and the current Secretary of Defense saying that Iran attacks, both Gates and Panetta, would be a disaster or a, quote, catastrophe, to quote Gates. And that also a larger regional war may start because of Syria and Turkey. And then once that begins, they'll sit back and say, well, now we've got to do something. And we've got the neocons, we've got Obama's handlers, and we've also got now Mitt Romney coming out and saying, we need to get behind the rebels that are attacking the Syrians. Those rebels happen to be al-Qaeda and other Wahhabist jihadis, predominantly out of Saudi Arabia. It's just amazing to watch them, both parties, working with al-Qaeda. And then I've got to be lectured all day about, well, the homeland has to take your rights because, you know, al-Qaeda wants to get you. So we're going to be getting into that. Also, front group for the psychopharmacological industrial complex. Teen Screen, they're now starting the New Freedom Initiative that Bush began but got postponed to forcibly screen your children for mental illness. This is all financed, and the handbook is written by Big Pharma. Insiders blew the whistles 5 years ago on this, but now it's here, so we're going to revisit the latest developments on that front. And I've got to read this whole article on air. I mentioned it last hour, but you've got to read it to believe it and get this out to everybody you know. Watson has all these links to Congress people, you name it, Miss USA, you name it, where for punishment for not doing the naked body scanners, they, I can't even say what they do on air, but they rape women with their hand. They go inside of them. And men, they grab the genitals and crush them. And in some cases tell you they're crushing them to make you pay. They say, I got to check and see what this is, and then crush them. And that's because they want that job. And a guy just pled guilty last week to robbing 500 and telling the guy, I'm taking 500 as punishment because you didn't go through the scanner. So the pat-downs are about humiliation to force you in to get a naked body scan of you and microwave you. And now they've announced they're going into shopping malls, highway checkpoints, mobile body scanners. The Army's running them. That's in the news today. Just, oh, it's what's that, honey? Oh, that's the Army. And they've got trucks you drive under, and the troops stand out in open-air x-rays that are killing them, soft killing them. Yeah, there's Forbes, the TSA coming to a highway near you. That was last year. It's now all over the place. I told you 10 years ago that was coming because I saw them on C-SPAN say it. But they've got scanners so powerful you drive under them. I have a Fox News piece about the Army running these in upstate New York. That was 3 years ago. And it shows the troops just standing around while high-powered x-rays, and they have the families driving under it. You have any idea how deadly that is? But they tell the troops, oh, it's not bad for you. By the way, I got some more experimental shots for you. Show up at the clinic at, you know, at 1600 hours or whatever. So all of this is going on. And again, I'm a bad guy because I'm pointing it out. The insanity of it all. But now, as a form of punishment, I mean, I saw this flying with Ventura a few times in Atlanta. I've told the story of these TSA screeners taking photos and laughing and, ooh, it's Jesse Ventura. It was literally like the South Park episode. The women were talking just like those women in that episode. Obviously, the people from South Park have been through it, so they probably Atlanta, so they know. But and they took about 5 minutes, and they grabbed his crotch, and then well, he really didn't like it when they went, you know, back between his Gluteus Maximus separation and shoved up in there. And he's like, East Germany, that's it. I'm not coming back. Oh, no, I hate this. And then they're like, ah, it's like a big carnival. Big carnival. It's all part of your new conditioning to make sure you're not al-Qaeda. So that's coming up. But let's go to your phone call. Sean in Pennsylvania. Welcome to the airwaves, Sean.
Yes, hi, Mr. Jones. Nice to talk to you.
It's nice to talk to you. Do you think I'm an extremist because I don't like having my testicles crushed by a pervert?
No, not at all. I have a good testimony, a visual testimony I had on September 15th of the TSA giving directions at 17th and JFK Boulevard in Philadelphia.
Oh, tell me about that. Oh, yeah. Good. Tell us about it.
Yeah, there was a 225-year anniversary of the Constitution in Philly, so I got off at 30th Street Station. There's TSA in there and a SWAT team and drug-sniffing dogs, and I was just walking down heading toward Independence Hall, and I just stopped because I looked over and I saw there's a TSA guy standing on the corner. So I figured I'd go see what he was doing. So I walked over to the corner and I figured I'd ask directions just to see instead of asking anything else. And he goes, yeah, it's right down the street. Just keep walking straight. I said, okay. So what are you guys doing here? Aren't you usually at the airport? He goes, we're just helping out, giving directions.
Oh, yeah. Like the Army in thousands of drills was just drilling for foreign countries. But, now they admit in South Carolina, in Colorado, in Texas, in Los Angeles, California, everywhere. They're just, we're regular Army. We're here now to search you on the highway. It's a free country. Really, I thought that's why I don't go to Mexico because of that. But again, you called in probably about something else. I didn't mean to divert you. Go ahead.
It's okay. No, that's fine. I'm glad we got off on a couple different things. But my mom started getting the flu shot 5 years ago. Now she has severe dementia and can barely speak.
Years ago, big studies came out. Just type it into the search engine. Alzheimer's vaccines, Alzheimer's flu shot. And they had a big study, what was it, about a decade ago. Three flu shots doubles your chances of Alzheimer's. That's why 25-year-olds are getting Alzheimer's now. But hey, we shouldn't be, it's good. Just take the shots, roll over and die. I mean, dementia's, it's a horrible thing. My grandfather got it before he died, but what's the big deal? I'm sorry, go ahead. I'm sorry to hear about your mother. I shouldn't be joking around.
Oh, well, thank you. No, I understand. I like your candid. You're a great candid guy. So I got one more point for you. Who do you think owns Independence Hall in Philadelphia?
The UN.
Well, you're right. Well, the federal government owns it.
But under treaty, World Heritage Site, they signed it over to the UN.
Oh, okay. It's 45 acres there, I guess they own the whole thing. Because the National Park Service, they watch it with their guns and everybody's, like you said, bugging their eyes out. It's crazy there.
Well, yeah. Guys, type in Independence Hall World Heritage Site. And see, what happens is the Park Service gets it, and then under treaty, they agree that it is to be regulated in perpetuity for all time by UNESCO. In fact, there's a UNESCO plaque at the facility.
Well, the National Park Service that I asked when I was there, I said, who owns, Independence Hall on the ground it sits on? They said, Philadelphia owns it. Everybody said the same thing. Philadelphia owns it. You could tell they were lying, but they still said the same thing. And I know it's nonsense because I looked it up. It's right on the National Park Service site. They said they took custody of it January 1st, 1951.
Yes, and then they turned it over to the UN. There it is, UNESCO, Culture, World Heritage, the list of World Heritage, Independence Hall, under UN control.
Very sad. Well, everybody there was lying. They had a big, 225th year, celebration, and the lady got up there from the National Park Service. She said, celebrate your building here. It's yours. I'm like, no, it's not. You're lying to us.
God bless you, sir. Good to hear from you. A lot of great points. Anything else?
No, that's it. Thank you.
Thank you. There goes the extremist. I knew that Independence Hall had been on the list, and that there'd actually been a controversy over the fact that they put a UN plaque there saying it was under UNESCO control. I don't know if it's still there, but guys, type in UNESCO plaque at Independence Hall. Click images. There'll probably be a photo of it. I was at the Grand Canyon two times in a row, and the global bots know to enforce on you. And when I was there in 1997, at the Grand Canyon, they came out and threatened to arrest us. That's on video in America Destroyed by Design. And then I was back there last fall And they had moved the visitor center to a new complex, and there was no one around. And I was around the side of the building where they had the UN signs. And a slave bot came 30 yards or so out of his way where I was shooting a video, because there's video of this. I uploaded it to YouTube and started interrupting me and saying he wanted to look at it. And how dare I criticize America? And I was saying, well, we're under UN control. Here's the sign. And he had American flags all over. And he was like, you don't. Because, again, I'm the bad one. When you tell people about what's happening, you're the bad one. It's the old parable of killing the messenger. Or no good deed going unpunished. And the guy tried to intimidate me. He was like, hold on, honey. This guy's got a problem. I want to see what this is. And I turned around. I was like, oh. He's like, you can't film me. Yeah, there's the UN shine at the Independence Hall. We found it for PrisonPlanet.tv viewers. Anyways, again, so I admit it. I'm bad. I shouldn't tell you about that. I should just take it all. Take whatever they do. Your call straight ahead, ladies and gentlemen, on the other side. When they announce on CNBC we're run by the UN, I should accept it. During the break, photo scrolled through on Infowars.com of a U.S. family, an American family during the Great Depression. You can see the mother. She's so incredibly skinny. You see the baby. The baby's fat because you know she's nursing it and literally giving up all her calories, dying to feed them. And then you see the older kids. They're real skinny as well. And I think about a university study. I forget which one. They estimate 7 million people starved to death during the Great Depression or died from complications from malnutrition. And I think about how moral and how hardworking people were back then. I haven't romanticized them. I've done a study of it. They were just light years above what we are, myself included. People are so decadent, so slob-like, and that's what's allowed incredible evil to just grow all around us. We have to admit we're in trouble. We have to admit we're in danger to turn this around. I mean, look, I've probably had 200 conversations with my wife convincing her to sacrifice our family and stay here. And to my wife's credit, she's prayed about it, and she says, all right, we'll stay here. My wife's smart. She's read a lot of history. She's lived all over the world. She knows the cost. This is real, folks. That's why I don't think some of you understand out there. You know, fighting the New World Order isn't some stick or some fun thing you do for so many of the activists out there that over the years have turned out to be bad people. This is all going to happen. It's all going to come to fruition. It's going to be bad. And we only hope to survive and have a remnant go through this. But make no mistake, God's watching each and every one of us, and God knows our hearts. And I just want to testify here on air that I am a wicked person. But my heart loves God and loves good, and I try to be good, and I try to tell the truth, and I try to be honest. And I do not feel worthy to be a radio talk show host speaking to millions of people. I am ashamed of the fact that I can't articulate what I know fully to you. I am not on some power trip, and I just feel sorry for people out there that are, because they have no idea that I really mean the things I say, and I'm right about the things I say in general. Let me tell you, folks, we got some really evil people running things, and things are getting darker by the minute. And it is a testament, though, to human liberty that so many AM and FM stations are turning this show on right now. Because people have heard me as guest on shows. They've heard the show the last 17 years, station owners, program directors, general managers. And they thought that guy's a lunatic. But now they've seen it all come true, much of it unfold. And they're thinking, wow, this is really true. We better do something about this. And I appreciate the fact that people have courage when they see the facts. I understand not wanting to believe this. Every day I wish to be wrong. Every day I wish this wasn't happening. Every day I think about how innocent my children are and how good they are. But it's because they are innocent and they are good. There is good in this world, and I will not go along with the evil consciously. That doesn't mean I'm high and mighty and have all the answers, but I'm here to tell you, folks, I've studied history, and I've studied the people that are running things right now. And believe me, it isn't Barack Obama or Mitt Romney, and they want to hurt you and your family. They want to shut down your jobs. They want to ship your jobs overseas. I was reading a comment in one of the videos on YouTube at the Alex Jones channel where they've got a whole bunch of trolls and they're attacking me. And one of my evil, guilty pleasures is I like being attacked. God has given me, I guess, this shield in my personality that when people lie about me and make stuff up and cherry pick or straw man, that it's entertaining. But I realize that's a sin, and I've repented of that, and I don't spend my time looking at that anymore. Not that I did a lot, a few hours a week. I mean, I'd call Paul Watson up and say, what's the new attack? You know, it's so entertaining. And I realize that's evil. And I've told the office not to be part of that guilty pleasure as well, because we don't have time to play games with all this and sit there and get into people attacking us and laughing at them. It's sick. But here's a comment. Alex Jones is the one setting up checkpoints nationwide. Alex Jones is the one shipping jobs overseas. Alex Jones is the one that published Ecoscience. Alex Jones wrote Agenda 21 and is putting it in nationwide and teaching it at all the colleges. Alex Jones is putting in cameras and microphones, I should add, on your streetlights and cameras in school bathrooms. Alex Jones is the one taping your phone calls. Is Alex Jones wrote the Patriot Act. Alex Jones created the NSA and is now admittedly Alex Jones is allowed to spy on you. And Alex Jones puts cancer viruses in your vaccines, and Alex Jones leaves the borders wide open, and Alex Jones paid $22 billion to ship General Motors overseas, and Alex Jones, again, that's my point. The enemy does want to make it all about Alex Jones, because then they can distract off of what they're doing. We're going to go to your phone calls and then a bunch of news on the TSA, the brainwashing of children, forced inoculation, and more coming up. In newspapers all over the United States and Europe, they have a PR rollout for the flu vaccines. And in many cases, it's admittedly paid for by Big Pharma. Here is the cover of Parade magazine and propaganda advertisement about one lucky little girl when there was a bacterial meningitis outbreak. In her state, she had the vaccine, so she was saved. And they quote myth bust in here, just like they do in this other article. These are just popping up everywhere out of another Texas newspaper, the News Journal, saying there are absolutely no harm or from vaccines. Don't let yourself be fooled by rumors. You heard it. There's nothing wrong with it. Of course, the facts are 180 degrees the opposite direction, but the system doesn't care. I'm going to be breaking that down after your phone calls here, and you need to call your friends and family and tell them to tune in, because this is a life-saving situation we're trying to talk about here. I want to plug, I know we got 7 new affiliates being sent, 3 of the others I'll plug tomorrow, but here's 4 of them we got in the last week. WCKG, 1530 AM, Chicago, Illinois, formerly WJJG. And continuing, you know, I used to be on WJJG about 13 years ago, and then it changed hands. Wow, that's wild. I didn't even realize that WCKG there in Chicago, Illinois, was a station I'd been on previously. Strange how stations come and go and change hands and things. KJMT 97.1 FM, Calico Rock, Arkansas. FTFS 940 AM, Texarkana, Texas. That's a big town there. And KFFK 1390 AM, Fayetteville, Arkansas. So I want to welcome all those stations on board. If you're new listeners, and this stuff's pretty scary, well, things were already happening before I told you about it. It's kind of like being told, hey, there's a... You'll be careful if you go back on the back 40. There's a big, mean Brahma bull back there. Might try to attack your truck. Oh, that's scary. You shouldn't have told me that. No, you need to know that if you're going to be driving around back there. Because if you didn't know you're driving around, it runs up and rams into your car. You need to know that was happening. It's kind of like there's a pit in your backyard, a 20-foot deep pit. And you're like, hey, be careful back there. They're digging a pit for a drainage ditch. Don't fall in it. It's not fear-mongering. It's telling you that that's going on. And it physically hurts me and physically makes me angry when I see these PR rollouts for vaccines that they know are making people sick, giving them cancer, and not protecting them from what they claim they're protecting them from. It makes me physically angry. because I've studied it. I've had all the scientists and brain surgeons and medical doctors on. And Big Pharma is just so monstrous. And just the last month, there have been scores of cases where they've pled guilty to shooting people up with live viruses on purpose to cause epidemics and knowing a drug's going to kill kids for asthma and then pushing it out there. I mean, it just makes my head spin. How many times have we learned about Big Pharma knowingly having HIV in a vaccine or a factor VIII or hepatitis? Or it's, again, a vaccine lab that's putting out the meningitis right now. Right as they had stuff written a week ago saying, you need the meningitis vaccines. And then magically there's the outbreak. I mean, this is so incredible. Parade Magazine, big feature story, guaranteed written weeks ago. Right on time for the viral meningitis and bacterial meningitis outbreaks. Just like it came out in California that last year, the whooping cough outbreak was from the vaccine. Guys, type that in and show people if you're watching on PrisonPlanet.tv. But the average person literally doesn't even know what's in a vaccine. They don't even know that antibiotics are for bacteria, not for viruses. They don't even know anything. I mean, and I guess if I was a winner, in quotes, I would go join the globalist and feed on people and be a big globalist operative because I know how people work. Instead, I'm here watching it in horror is engaged in. Now, that's not it. Whooping cough vaccine proven short-lived. No, it came out that they were actually spreading measles, mumps, rubella, whooping cough from vaccines in California. It was something like I think the headline is 9 out of 10 whooping cough cases from the vaccine. It was mainstream news, but because you've got real journalists reporting on it in the local papers, and you've also got side-by-side the paid-for garbage. You know what? I'm already getting into this now. I'm going to cover it more after I get to your calls. Now let's hurry through calls. Josh in Texas, thanks for holding her on the air.
Alex, how's it going? First-time caller, long-time listener.
I'm welcome.
I'm fired up, so do you mind if I give you a war cry?
Yeah! So loud, it just overdrove your... for new listeners, I've said, you know, in the past, for people that are in these comas, it's good to yell and scream because it gets people shaken out of their trance. Go ahead, sir.
I'm awake, Alex. I'm alive. I'm a human being. People need to understand you are free. You're a man. These other people that are trying to control your life are nothing but men. Stand up for who you are. Be proud of who you are. You're an American citizen, or you got here as fast as you can. Stand up for your freedom. This is your life. These are your rights. This is the time. There is no time for messing around. It is now. Stand up for who you are. Find yourself.
Every bit of freedom we've got today was fought for. The only reason the U.S. has had so much freedom is our ancestors wouldn't be pushed around. And when you act like sheep, the wolves come. Go ahead.
I'm 22 years old, Alex. I've been listening to you for 4 years. You have woken me up. I want to thank you not for who you are, but for your work. You have led me through the darkness, and through that, I have been starting brush fires in the minds of men. It is amazing to see somebody who realizes the truth and to wake up, to become alive and actually get out of this trance. Wake up, people. It's time.
God bless you, sir. I appreciate your points. Anything else?
No, Alex, God bless you, and keep doing what you're doing, man.
Let's talk to Robert calling from FEMA Region 10. What, are you in Oregon? Are you in a former Washington State? And where are you calling from in FEMA Region 10?
I'm Washington State.
All right. Formerly, again, part of the U.S., now under global control here in occupied former United States. What's on your mind today?
Just wanted to let you know I'm a peace officer for the Constitution of the United States.
Well, that's good. That's wonderful news.
Well, I'll let you know, Alex, I've been training a new officer just come on in the last week, and I sat him down and I explained to him, even though you were a former Marine, you will follow the U.S. Constitution and you will know the Bill of Rights. And I told him that police work is a lot of gray area and it's not black and white. And we have a lot of discretion and we need to treat our citizens who pay our wages every month with respect, and we're here to serve them. And I told them that whatever they teach you at the academy, I said, you're going to come back and you're going to unlearn. I said, because most of the people that we deal with are, which are bottom 10% of society, are bad, but the 90% of the people are decent, and they just want to be served, respected, and protected.
Wow. Well, I wish I lived in your town. I mean, there are so many good police, and I hate to buy into the globalist program, but it's hard to not do, where they have these big city police federally trained. They allow the bad ones to rise to the top so that the public starts fearing the police. The police then know the public doesn't like them. That then compacts them into a gang mentality so that they feel like it's us against them. Well, it's now time to break that. And there are still some good police academies in the country, because I've read some of the curricula. But more and more, it is a militarized, in-your-face system. I mean, overall, you must be a small department, or how are you stopping the globalist infiltration?
Well, you woke me up about 2 years ago, Alex. I came across InfoWars, I don't know, on the online or something. But anyways, I buy the bulk of your new magazines. I set those out around the town, around the guys I work with. We put on InfoWars nightly news in the morning time. Some of the guys I work with call it brainwashing TV, but we watch it. and what's great is I actually sat down a couple of my coworkers last week, and we pulled up the 27 amendments, and we read through them. And I told them, listen, guys, we can't forget why we're here. And I'm fortunate. I've been a cop for 15 years. I'm a training officer. And listen, our department doesn't drink the federal fluoride, so we don't go to their training. So that probably helps.
Very, very exciting. Wow. And again, you know, for guys that think they're being brainwashed with this type of information, if anything, I'm just burnt out. So I rant and rave because I'm so sick of all this. But, I mean, did they see the Senate report? I'm trying to find it. Here it is. Intelligence effort named citizens, not terrorists, never named one real terrorist. And then it goes on, the Army new training manual characterizes people frustrated with mainstream ideologies as terrorists and believe in government conspiracies. I mean, look at Fast and Furious. This is exactly what I've been saying for 10 years, that it was never about al-Qaeda. They were going to flip it around on the American people. I mean, any of the guys or ladies that don't think there's some truth to what we're saying, it's admitted that al-Qaeda is being used against Syria. I mean, do they think anything about that?
Well, I'll be honest with you, Alex. I think, you know, police department's just like a demographic of the, you know, the citizens of the United States. You've got a small percentage that are awake, and the rest aren't because they're too busy, you know, worrying about their boats and all that kind of stuff. But I have learned, I just keep laying seed on the ground, and I just keep educating them, and then you get guys who'll ask questions. But, you know, the thing is, the federal government and the money they provide is like crack. And the problem is that these departments are getting addicted to it, so they feel obligated to do what the federal government tells them because they're giving them the money. And that's the local governments have to get off the federal boob.
I hear you, and God bless you. Wonderful to hear you call, sir. Thank you for your service to the Bill of Rights, the Constitution, and service to yourself. You know, when you serve, ladies and gentlemen, when you serve liberty and freedom, all of us do that have chosen to fight for liberty, because you got to fight for it. You are serving yourself and your children and your family. That's what's so frustrating. We talk about cops all day. They're nothing compared to bureaucrats and people on average. That's your Bill of Rights and Constitution, too. I mean, that's what makes us different than North Korea. We're just more dirt if we don't have that. That is precious. People fought and died for that. That's why you revere the flag, because it represents the blue sky and God above and the stars in the sky, the evidence of God's creation. And you've got the red that signifies the blood that's been given to fight for liberty. And then you've got the white that symbolizes the states. I'm going from memory what the American flag symbolizes, but I think I basically got it right. The point is that, look, we're in a trance. I don't know how else to explain this to people. I mean, I've got this article here with links to mainstream news. where you've got members of Congress, the list goes on and on, where TSA says, we're going to punish you, and grabs your genitals and starts crushing them. And now the TSA is coming to police departments and saying, we are going to give you federal training, and then you're allowed to set up checkpoints at the basketball game or whatever and grope people. Why do they always create a new agency? Hitler did it. Others have done it. Because the old agency will have some type of code. Even the FBI tries to follow the Bill of Rights and Constitution. So you can't have the FBI in there saying, oh, now it's okay to go to the prom and grope everyone that comes in, quote, for their safety in this nanny state. So they create the TSA. And now TSA takes an eight-hour course, so they can supposedly read your mind. And now all over the country, they have the TSA training police. Well, I've had a TSA course, so now I can set up a checkpoint here on the side of the highway and dig through your stuff without warrants and grope you. Because the TSA said so? Because Homeland Security said so? Why, they say the NSA can spy on us without warrants? It's illegal. It's illegal. And it's time to say no to all of this. It's time to say no. It doesn't have to get worse if we just wake up to it. We'd already be in World War III right now if you didn't have the secretaries of defense and all these other people saying no, no, no. But the bureaucracy is run by other people, and that's why they want to go to war. And I've got all that news. I've already mentioned it. Let's continue with your calls. Let's talk to... some reason I can't, the screen's a little bit too far away there. You know what? I've started doing the show over here. We might want to move the call stuff over here. That way I can just look at it over here and know who we're going to next. Christian in Arkansas, you're on the air. Go ahead.
How you doing, Alex? Good to talk to you.
Good to talk to you, sir. I'm doing okay.
I'm a 14-year veteran of the Army Infantry, and I've been listening to you since just before they came and scooped up Brandon Raub in that great illegal way that they did. I got a couple of bits of intelligence for you here. I've got a friend of mine that has been a New York police officer for 20 years, and I was wondering if you're aware of Operation Empire Shield.
It rings a bell. Tell me about it.
He's telling me that there's federal troops stationed all over the city at the foot of each bridge. They're searching trucks as they cross the bridge. They're working hand-in-hand with law enforcement, of course, which we know is completely illegal, according to the Constitution, which was unfortunately suspended by the NDAA. I've got a friend that works in Michigan in the trucking industry, and he said that the volume of trucking in the state has taken a huge dip in the last couple of months.
Yeah, I found it. It's army.mil. I don't mean to interrupt you. I'll hold you over if need be. This is important. Guys, put this on screen for TV viewers. Just type in Operation Empire Shield. JTF Empire Shield still serving after 8 years in the homeland. And, yeah, it's the Army. Oh, yeah, I mean, sure, I've seen the National Guard and regular Army. I've had them come over and actually threaten to arrest me or beat me. If you guys can't punch the computer up, just use the camera to zoom in across the hall, and then we can show it that way. We've got a camera down or a feed down. But JTF Empire Shield still serving after 8 years. It's an end game. I have troops with sidearms run over when I'm just filming in Times Square and threaten to physically attack me. And it says, Staff Sergeant Michael Wilson stands outside, watch outside Penn Station as part of New York National Guard. And yes, hundreds of thousands of people now a month are searched and the Army is involved. And now they're unfolding into other cities. Go ahead and keep elaborating on that as we go to break.
Well, he didn't give me too much in terms of specifics in that. He just wanted me to be aware of it. Also, my son and I recently traveled through St. Louis where you had that caller, Jim, called in a while back.
Where they had regular Army on the street. Stay there. We're going to come back. Yeah. And now they're admitting, oh, the troops are here to stay. They're just going to run checkpoints in St. Louis and Houston, Texas. And, you know, just, oh, it's just troops. You know, it's the new American way. Okay, so I just read to you from Reuters and from Wired Magazine where they admit the terrorists are gun-owning libertarian conservatives and veterans, and that it is a total takeover of society, And then I have articles where all over the country in the last week, suddenly they're not even calling it drills now. They're having army on the streets, going through neighborhoods, stopping cars, searching vehicles. And they're just announcing, hey, they're going to rotate through your towns. This is pure acclamation for the collapse of society. Now, remember, they say they're doing it because of al-Qaeda while they run al-Qaeda and put al-Qaeda into Libya and Syria. But they're now phasing out. Big Sis has said, no, it is now domestic groups. And they've got all these TV shows coming out, like Founding Fathers, Homeland, you name it, where the veterans are terrorists that are going to blow everybody up and work with al-Qaeda. And the Army manual say the Tea Party works with al-Qaeda. Remember that Army manual came out a month ago? We had Stuart Rhodes on about it. So they're now branding over to, where'd Bob go? Oh, he's with al-Qaeda. And they think you're so stupid, they run al-Qaeda publicly, the banks that have hijacked our country. And it's just pure evil. They've got these young 20-year-old men and women who play video games all day when they're not, you know, out in active duty that think they're going to have a big war with us. The older people, they're the main enemy. They know the troops are going to wake up. So they're hoping the young troops aren't woken up before they can use them against the old troops. Hitler actually did that. So did Stalin. This actually is a normal thing under tyranny. But I need to shut up. Christian in Arkansas, finish your story. So, yeah, you called in about the name of they also have Brigade Homeland. That's the term they use for regular army in the streets of America. Empire Shield. But they also have troops in police uniforms pulling triggers on veterans. When they have a veteran that they're going to raid their house for whatever the case is, they send in Army or Marines. This is highly classified information, but we've confirmed it, and they kill you in your house. That's part of a covert operation. The cops think they've been let in on the big secret. But I'm sorry, I finished your story about driving through St. Louis.
Well, I was just going to say that my son and I drove through St. Louis not terribly long ago, and we saw active duty troops patrolling the beltway, or the loop, whatever you call it, around the city there. And it just tied in neatly to the things that you've been saying. And also, as a veteran, and I'm retired for PTSD, I'm a veteran of close combat, so they know that I'm one of the war fighters. So them scooping people up the way they have been really concerns me. And I'll say blatantly, point blank, that should they come and pay me a visit, I ain't going with them.
Well, and once the Civil War starts, they'll be able to pick off, like at the Alamo, they'll be able to pick off small groups of veterans by themselves. But once they start killing the veterans and trying to arrest them, the veterans aren't going to be waiting in their house the next time. It'll be just like the Alamo. They'll be able to wipe groups of patriots out up front. But remember, that's the beginning of the end for the globalists. That's why they haven't killed me yet, because they don't want Alex Jones to be a martyr, a little Alamo, a little Goliad massacre. They don't want to give us any martyrs up front. They want to try to move in. When will they move against us? When they set off a nuke in a major city and then say the Tea Party works with al-Qaeda. That's a meme. Can you imagine being in an officer group in the police or the military, and they in a group, and they're teaching officers this. They're teaching them that the Tea Party works with al-Qaeda and is going to attack. I mean, that who buys that? I mean, come on, folks. Who buys the veterans are the number one terror threat? Well, yeah, they're going to call veterans terrorists when they try to kill you and round you up. Does anybody realize the architecture of what they're setting up? It's crazy. Anything else you'd like to add?
It's extremely difficult to convince people. That's one of the things that I'm having the most difficult time with is to convince folks that they've been duped.
Yeah, I know. People don't want to admit they've been duped. But ladies and gentlemen, I mean, you can give them Reuters admitting Homeland Security's targeting the average American. It has nothing to do with terrorism. We'll be right back. Stay with us. All right, I'm going to continue with a few calls now. Then I'm getting into the big report of the day, the most important info, how they're abusing our kids with these bioweapons known as vaccines. That is coming up at the start of the next segment. Then I'll continue with the TSA abuse, the latest economic numbers that we're getting, and your phone calls. Right now, let's talk to Devon in Canada. Thank you for calling in today. Welcome.
Hey, I'm first-time caller, long-time listener, and I was just wondering, in Canada, if martial law comes, what will happen in Canada, and what we should look out for here in Canada for the coming days?
Canada is owned and run by the Queen, as you know. She has about half the property up there. Her governor general has suspended parliament three times. They don't do as she orders. And her propaganda arm is always, you know, advertising how powerless she is. She's probably the most powerful person, if not the most. Lord Rothschild may be more powerful. That's debated. But Canada appears to be a safe zone overall, that they're going to have social engineering, forced inoculations, a lot of arrest for your speech. But Canada is, I'd have to say, physically going to be safer than the United States during this engineered collapse, I have to say. But again, nothing certain. But Canada is ahead of us in many respects with the police state. But it's not being targeted for total re-education, because you're seen as already being isolated and pretty much under their control, so they can take their time with you later.
Yeah. Well, I've even looked, and I haven't seen much for the FEMA camps or anything around here in Canada. So I was just wondering for the Canadian viewers, is what was going on.
I mean, what are you, 26 million people?
A little more, I believe.
Yeah, 28 million now? I forget.
Something like that.
Yeah, I mean, they need you to extract the resources right now. Right now, they just want to break the U.S. and Western Europe and Japan fully for re-engineering. Don't worry, they'll get around to you later. I mean, they're giving you the shots, and you got the higher cancer rates and stuff. They're taking good care of you. They're making sure. But they're going to take their time on you. We're up next on the slaughter block, like the Russians were, with the banker re-engineering. They dumped out the commies to get that job done. No, you're not up next in the slaughter chute here at the slaughterhouse. You're on up the chute a ways. In fact, I'd say Canada's pretty much at the Canada, Switzerland. You're pretty much at the end of the line. You're kind of the last in line.
Some people say that if there was a war on the U.S., that Canada would be where people would send their troops through. Like we would be some sort of gateway or...
Yeah, but you're so huge. I mean, you're so huge. What, you got people on the West Coast and East Coast, mainly the East Coast? I mean, yeah, if they're going to send Russians over the North Pole, the Russians aren't invading jack squat. The Russians are too busy robbing each other to get anything done. The only time the Russians are a problem is you attack them, then they'll all mobilize and do whatever they're told. The Russians aren't ever an issue until you attack them. Then they all line up like army ants. You better look out.
Well, thank you for helping me out with that, and it's always good listening to your show.
Thank you so much. I appreciate your call. Yeah, the Russians are not an issue, folks, until you mess with them. And then they'll just send everybody they have. But the Russians have gone from, well, their population is down like 30%. I mean, the global, that's why they've reversed the eugenics move. And I'm not saying that mafia system's good, but it's certainly not a scientific pure evil. I mean, the Russians pay you to have kids. You know, the Russians at least have some nationalism, as bad as they are, as bad as their corruption is. They've already been down the New World Order path. They've somewhat broken away from it. They're just trying to regroup and have some kids. And the globalists want back in to take it over to get rid of the Russians. The American people are in the same boat as the Russians. We shouldn't be enemies with them. Our enemies are the globalists. That's our enemy. We'll be right back. I'm Alex Jones. Key report on the bioweapon attacks that are ongoing straight ahead. Are you going to avoid the soft kill weapons? Have you warned someone about the soft kill weapons? Stay with us. Monday through Friday, 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central. 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. I desperately sit here on air, surrounded by pure evidence of absolute scientific evil taking over our planet, and I desperately, in the footsteps of Paul Revere, try to alert my fellow humans to evil running rampant. Now, I don't like Hugo Chavez, and then I'm getting into the vaccine news. I don't like the oppression. I don't like his communism. He's not just a socialist. I don't like some of his activities. But I do know the West has used fake right-wingers to also exploit Latin Americans. One of my crew members who does a great job working up here went back to Venezuela to vote. Absolutely hates Hugo Chavez. Had their family business basically taken over by the communist. And he's now won And that's either a triumph of election fraud, though Reuters is saying it's a convincing win, and they break that down, or whether or not it's the triumph of having people on the dole. More than half of Venezuela gets some type of government benefit, just like the U.S., because once you go red, I guess you don't really hardly ever go back until things totally collapse. And the country has been rotting since Chavez got control of it. So that's disgusting, and I meant to mention that at the start of the show, but there it is. Okay, this information I'm about to cover is a life and death situation. And I don't want listeners to take my word on this. I want you to go research the claims that I'm going to make here today. Because vaccines are being pushed, hundreds and hundreds of them, on the population. You see calls in the news to make inoculation mandatory for everyone. And there's so many different angles and facets to all of this. Number one, the media lies and says it's the law to take vaccines and that you will be arrested if your children don't take them. Or that it's the law to go to school that you have to have them. We're in no state of the union. Is it the law to take vaccines? Now, that's 100% fact. They have a waiver that they have at the health department to a non-law. It's a regulation, but they ask you to get it, which then puts you on a list. I don't do it. Okay? They even try to force homeschoolers to do it. My children end up going to the quasi-private school homeschool where they're 2 days a week at the private school, 3 days a week at home. We just explain and show people the paperwork. We're not doing the waiver. Then there's the argument that, well, if you haven't had the shots, and they do that in Parade magazine, that you're going to get others sick. Well, wait a minute. If you're protected by the deadly vaccine, well, then why should I have to take it? Why am I going to make you get it? And what you see in August, before every school year, you hear it on radio, you see it on TV, you read it in the newspaper, it's bombarding the public in July into August, September, that it's the law. You will be arrested if your child doesn't have the shot. Now, what they do is they kick your kid out, don't tell you there's a waiver, then they trigger truancy laws, which the courts have found aren't applicable if they've kicked your kid out. So it's constructive, organized fraud. So that's not a good place to start with the vaccines. Then you add that Bayer, GlaxoSmithKline, all the big vaccine conglomerates were founded in the U.S., England, Germany, and France. All were founded in those countries about 150 years ago. And they developed the theory of eugenics, and they funded the Kaiser Wilhelm Institute. They got most nations on Earth, from Japan to Mexico, by the 1930s to adopt eugenics. They set up family planning courts in Japan, Mexico, the U.S., Canada, England, Germany, the Netherlands, hundreds of countries. The Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, the British East India Company, the Dutch East India Company, they would give millions of dollars, and that was in 20s and 30s money, to government officials if they would install this. That's where you got family courts, where there's no judge, no jury. They would order you in if you made a B-minus or less, they would sterilize you. I've got clips of newsreels in my film Endgame. So, see, I know what these health departments are. They are agents of racial hygiene. I know the history. And it's so frustrating to know fluoridation was the Soviet model to reduce fertility and dumb people down, and to even have Harvard studies out admitting it reduces IQ. We're being killed. So they're lying to you saying it's the law. They are also running around getting in everybody's face saying you're going to make other people sick if you don't take it. And the point is the entire history of Big Pharma. Remember 4 or 5 years ago, I use this a lot because everybody seems to have heard of this. Bayer Pharmaceutical, from Australia to France to the U.S., over 11 years was shipping out millions of ampules of factor VIII blood clotting agent to hemophiliacs and others, knowing it had HIV and hepatitis in every ampule and was a death sentence. Directly, intravenously, you're going to get hepatitis, you're going to get it. And it was in the minutes where they knew, and it was on purpose. It wasn't that they didn't care about killing people. They want you dead. People say, oh, the elite doesn't care about us. No. Oh, they care a great deal about making sure you're in a pine box. They care a great deal about killing you. Let's get that straight. And I'm here risking my life telling you this because we're now reaching the point, ladies and gentlemen, we're reaching millions of new people a week. The system does not like this. I've been told through different government functionaries, I better shut up. Well, you know what? I'm not shutting up. I'm not signing on to all these deaths. It is a great honor if you destroy me because I was in the service of humanity. I win. I don't want to die. I'm deep down nostalgic and sad for the life I could have led if I'm struck down. But that's the cost of survival of the species. That's what I fear for. That's what I'm worried about. And you eugenicist, I indict you. You're not trying to empower humanity. You're not trying to build up. Your eugenics that you teach at the lower level, that's the outer porch eugenicist is, oh, we kill the infirm, the dumb, the stupid, we don't let them breed or we kill them, and then we breed the elites to make this perfect human. But perfect to you is cold-blooded, murderous, and controlling. You guys are all inbred and have a lot of medical problems if you study it. That's why you're wanting to purify the race of humanity, because you yourselves took already highly aggressive, sociopathic people in many cases, interbred those to make the super psycho breed that is elites worldwide, whether they be Japanese, German, Jewish, Britannic, it doesn't matter. You all operate the same. Ruling class blacks in Africa operate the same. Ruling classes in Mesoamerica acted the same. I've studied the sociology, the anthropology, the archaeology. I've studied it all. And let me tell you, folks, I know what's going on. And they are setting a precedent to force into our bodies vaccines. There's another lie there. Lies within lies within lies. This is why I get so frustrated to communicate all this knowledge, because it's all inner, multivariate, connected. Interlaced, interconnected. These aren't even vaccines in most cases. These are viruses that are really lab engineered to the level of nanotech. All a virus is, they argue whether it's alive or dead, it's a computer program. It's alive, but in the way a computer is. It's a replicating, self-replicating DNA, RNA, it's RNA, but it programs DNA. Okay? And we think of it as a virus as bad. There are many good viruses. But the point is, we just know of the bad ones because that's what's causing the problem. That's what gets studied. They've gone in and created nanotech reengineering systems that have, I believe the evidence is clear, already being used. If they'll use fluoride to dumb us down, some of us are obviously immune for whatever reason. There's a lot of studies showing that if you already have the papillomavirus, that it will block the uptake of the same families that are used as jump carriers. And I've had scientists on about that. But the point is that they're already, the public's already exhibiting zombiosis, basically, to use that term, zombification. There's a big study out today about TV zombifying people, even if it's passively on in the background, to where they can't even communicate. So what they're calling vaccines aren't even really vaccines, these new classes. It's something they inject into you that attacks certain brain cells, attacks certain organs, certain glands, re-engineers things, changes your DNA. But the point is, I now see the second wave. They always do it in August, and they always do it again October, November, pushing the flu vaccines. You walk into a Walgreens or a CVS or any of these stores, it's literally 20, 30, 40 signs everywhere, get your shot, and they're pushing it at you at the counter. And then it gets into the hoax, and I'll cover when we get back, the main report, that they've never chosen the right flu to guess the year before what it's going to be that year. So it's never helped anybody, but it isn't meant to. How do you trust Big Pharma that's got a history of killing troops in secret experiments and killing hemophiliacs and injecting black people with syphilis and Latin Americans and American troops and nerve gassing them? I mean, it's like you wouldn't let these people, you wouldn't want to live next door to them. You wouldn't want to live in the same block. I mean, you want to be scared of somebody. This is them. They are the greatest fusion of evil you can imagine because they're interbred. And as you know, in any mammal species, interbreeding creates all sorts of psychotic behavior on top of the genetic aggression that they have from leadership traits. Hyper-mutated into the ruling class. Here we go. We'll be right back. Let me tell you, folks, not taking chances has gotten us where we are today. Good people can stand up and defeat tyranny anytime they want to. And as the song says, we got to come straight on and just tell it like it is. Reality is wild. All right, let's get back to the vaccines. So I start seeing, without even looking, 4, 5, 6 articles every day. In fact, every paper. This weekend, I picked up the Statesman and flipped through it and found an article pushing vaccines. I mean, it's PR. In most cases, it's paid for. And Parade Magazine is a advertisement insert of thousands of newspapers across the United States. And it says, one lucky little girl, when she was just 15 months old, the little girl in Minnesota almost died during an outbreak of bacterial meningitis. Here's what her ordeal can tell us about the hidden dangers of the anti-vaccine movement. Now, folks, the vaccine movement is people that have been damaged by it. And then it's got the article right here. Oh, you know, they wish they would have done it. They wish they would have gone along. And, you know, if somebody doesn't take it, then they spread it to other people. Well, wait a minute. I thought if you have the vaccine, you're protected. And it, you know, dispels the so-called myths. Well, here's the deal. Print mainstream media isn't even going to exist soon because people know what you're about. It says parents who skip some vaccines or delay the age at which they're given. And then it just goes through and basically demonizes all those people. So should unvaccinated children be permitted in public schools? This is all the eugenics movement setting the precedent that they're the good guys and they're going to tell you what's safe. Now, you can argue whether the science of immunization is real or not or is dangerous. But there's no debate that the people running Big Pharma are evil and have been caught in every scandal you can imagine. Look at this article out of the News-Journal. The News Journal. This is out of Texas. Take your medicine. Getting a flu shot is part of being a good neighbor. And it basically says you're going to disease everyone if you don't take it. And the public's so dumbed down, they think, yeah, I've had my shot, but you're going to give it to me if you haven't had yours. Hey, moron, you supposedly took it. Now, listen to this. They go on to say there is absolutely no harm from getting a vaccination. Don't let yourself be fooled by raw rumors. No proof. No fact. But then they go on to say, oh, but it's not 100% safeguard to get the shot. You won't get the flu. See, because they know people are going, man, I got sick after I took that. And they say, yeah, you might feel puny. You might get sick. But that's part of being well. I just read from this. And this same thing is in Parade, different variants of it. It's everywhere. It's on the nightly news. And what do reporters do? They go regurgitate this and then wonder why their news directors tell them to write about this or do a radio show or TV show about this. Because you look at the ads, half the ads in some of these newspapers are Big Pharma. TV, turn it on at night. They run the show. And they now have government-run health care. And under the Model States Health Emergency Powers Act, they say they're going to make people take it. If you go back 10 years ago, they tried to make 14 million first responders take it, tried to make them take smallpox. It killed a bunch of people, so they stopped it. Now, let me just go over some articles about what this is doing to people. Flu jab linked to fits in under fives. And it says, this is London Telegraph, doctors have been told don't give it under fives because of a tenfold increase in epilepsy, some of it permanent, in children that got the flu shot. That's in England. I mean, so obvious they had to stop. Whoa, whoa, whoa. This bat's a little too strong. We're only supposed to hurt some of them. Don't go all the way. This will even wake the doctors up. Got to move slower. Got to move slow, okay? Hey, by the way, you heard them say it's a conspiracy theory or what was the quote? Wild rumors. Wild rumors. Don't be, oh, well, here's the CDC. 20 pages. Type in CDC possible side effects from vaccines. And it goes over it. And you know what's in here? Death. You know what else is in here? Being paralyzed. Guillain-Barré. You know what else is in here? All sorts of stuff. Go read it for yourself. Oh, seizures. Nonstop crying. High fever. That's the moderate problems. Severe problems. Long-term seizures, coma, or lowered consciousness. Permanent brain damage. Oh, but I mean, wait a minute. Permanent brain damage? I thought I was said wild rumors. I mean, they don't want you to go read. Read the insert. It tells you on the insert it can kill you. Okay? You understand that? So they pay to have news articles going, there's nothing. Zero chance you can get hurt. Meanwhile, the insert says, by the way, this will kill you. We'll be right back with more. Stay with us. So I have a stack of mainstream news articles where the flu shots are making kids die, making them have epilepsy, for life, not just having seizures, but getting epilepsy. Guillain-Barré getting paralyzed for life, multiple deaths per state, per year, articles from Gardasil that they knew was killing people in the trials. And you go to medical doctors, they'll lie to you and say that there's not even mercury in it. And again, it's the type of mercury. It's okay to have mercury in like fish or something. It's bound and it's natural mercury. It's not the pharmacological grade right into your blood. That's what has the big effect. But that's a side issue. Continuing here, this article out of the News Journal. In fact, show people, guys, type in "get your flu shot" and then click news, and you will see, I bet, thousands of articles right now saying the same thing in different ways that Parade magazine's saying with the sweet little girl that gets all her shots now. And this article that says there is absolutely no harm from getting a vaccination. Don't let yourself be fooled by wild rumors. Notice the Longview News Journal out of Longview, Texas, does not have a name on this. Oh, there it is. Why it's important to get your flu shot. Oh, 17 hours ago. Oh, look at that. Take care. Common myths about flu vaccine. And I guarantee you that'll tell you how great it is. Life works. Where to get the flu shot. Oh, it's for life. Seasonal flu shots now available. I mean, look at that. Just, 60 articles there, 23 there. And I guarantee you it's minimizing. I'll guarantee you there's thousands of articles out right now. Time to get your flu shot. What you need to know. Here, keep scrolling down. Well, that's just the articles today. 506 news articles to get your flu shot with that in the headline. Time to get your flu shot, and surprisingly, babies are getting it. Yeah, up until 4 years ago, they would never tell a pregnant woman to take any vaccine, and the inserts all said don't take it. But now they decided to just, hey, let's see if we can get away with it. Be sure and give extra shots if you're pregnant, which is well known to cause all sorts of brain damage and miscarriages. But hey, why not? Again, they're just seeing how much they can get away with here. In the face of all this, I mean, they had Rick Perry come out and say, it's the law, you got to take Gardasil. And we said it is not, and people were calling the show 6 years ago when that first happened saying, Alex, if the governor says it's the law. And I said, I promise. And I went and showed people, and we started the national movement. And then the media finally picked up and going, hey, it's not a law. It's a regulation. He just told the health department to tell schools to mandate it. But a mandate's not a law. They just push it. Was Rick Perry's HPV vaccine mandate wrong? And then it goes on, to break it down. Again, not the law. Now they say, let boys take it. Boys are bad. And then they admit on the insert, doesn't protect you from papilloma. Doesn't protect you from the cancer that only kills a few thousand a year. But look, CDC vaccine immunizations, side effects. This is from cdc.gov /vaccines/vac-gen/side-effects.htm. And, I mean, death, coma, but hey, don't worry, moderate problems, seizures, nonstop crying, high fever, severe problems, long-term seizures, coma, lowered consciousness, brain damage, permanent brain damage. Well, I mean, what's wrong with that? I mean, what's I mean, permanent brain damage, death. I mean, what? Oh, but I mean, wait a minute. That can't be true. The CDC's involved in wild rumors, ladies and gentlemen, because look, the Longview Journal says right here there's absolutely no harm from getting a vaccination. Right there. Absolutely no harm from getting a vaccination. Don't let yourself be fooled by wild rumors. That, well, there you go. So who do I believe? People I know whose kids died after shots, and all the brain damaged kids I know, and all the statistics, and all the scientists, and their own admissions, or oh no, the Longview Journal with no name on it, or you know what, Parade Magazine. They say if I don't take the shot, I'm going to make you sick. That's what Dina Dell says. And here's some other ones. Again, I mean, here's the British government said stop giving kids vaccines under five. It's causing brain damage. I don't know, London Telegraph. I'm a bad guy for reading that. Oh, but don't worry. A hoax within a hoax. Rhode Island becomes the first state to mandate flu shots for healthcare workers. Not the law. It's a hoax. It's a mandate. Rhode Island, they became the first state in the nation to mandate seasonal flu shots for all healthcare workers. Next, it'll be police and firefighters. So wake up. Those of you that are into following orders, get ready to get brain damaged. Overriding the objections of healthcare workers, unions, and the Rhode Island affiliate of the American Civil Liberties Union, Health Director Michael D. Fine filed new regulations. Regulations. Not law. Requiring seasonal flu shots for doctors, nurses, and others. Employees, temporary workers, and volunteers working for hospitals, nursing homes, home care agencies, and other healthcare organizations. Workers can be exempted from the requirement for documented medical reasons, but no conscientious or religious objection. Bull! They are moving towards the fourth shot, and they say that in parade. That's, well, in California, they give your kids shots without consent. Man, I tell you, California is the model. I mean, not even the Soviets did that. And you got to read this article that Mike Adams put together back in July, because it indexed a bunch of mainstream admissions where all the major vaccine makers just in a month admitted to every horrible thing you can imagine. You know, putting the pathogens in the shots to spread it to sell more. Lying and putting, in one case, one company put more than 10 drugs on the market they knew had zero help and killed people, including asthma drug for kids they knew did help no one and killed people. Oh, but let's just trust them and roll our sleeves up right now, right now, right now. I mean, they're killing people, man. That's why I'm yelling and screaming here. I'm nobody. I'm a piece of junk. What does that say about those of you that can't even wake up and get upset about this? It's normal to see cancer exploding, diabetes exploding, neurological disorders exploding, and then to have, guys, will you bring me eco-science? It's back there in the bookshelf. I don't see where it is now since you guys straightened up in here. A big, thick, giant white book. Yeah, there it is, bottom shelf. You bring it to me? Come on in, Chris. Thank you. I mean, you know, I've actually scanned through. Aaron's actually read them. Four books written by John P. Holdren talking about jacking your food and water. And he's the White House science czar. You see this? The whole thing's scanned online. Just type eco-science in. This is a White House science czar. John P. Holdren, Paul Ehrlich, Ann Ehrlich, both top eugenicists, calling for global government and poison in your butt. Now, you better go read this, okay? This isn't a damn, excuse me, this is not a game, okay? Sick of it. I've had enough. Man, I mean, I do not like watching this anymore. I mean, I've gotten to the point where I realize there's no future if we don't beat these people, where I actually have basically zero fear now of being killed, imprisoned, tortured, whatever. I'm not even worried anymore. And I tell you, because I realize how bad things are. You understand that? There's no way I'm just going to go into the future just trusting the system anymore. And I'm just going to trust in God, that whatever God's will and mission is for me, whatever Jesus Christ's mission is, I'm going to follow that. And let me tell you something. These 501c3 run churches, I didn't know that Presbyterian churches all over the country are taking the crosses out. I was told about it this weekend and went and looked it up and found cases of it. I'm not a Presbyterian. I'm just, the point is, this is insane. I mean, this country, just at every level, is going straight to Hades in a handbasket. We are under psych warfare attack. And I'm sitting here looking at so many cases of them. I've got articles here, mainstream, 67,000 kids in India last year paralyzed after being given the polio vaccine. I mean, it's insane. Paralysis cases spike in wake of Bill Gates' polio vaccination effort. Confirmed, India's polio eradication campaign caused 47,000. Then later it was 67,000 cases of vaccine-induced polio paralysis. ABC News. I just can't even handle it anymore. Uncovered FDA documents reveal 26 more Gardasil deaths. Vaccine made individuals more sick, worsened H1N1 symptoms. ABC News reported on that. Mercola was linked to that. It just goes on and 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 on. And then I constantly run into yuppies, and they're usually college grads with a PhD in biology, you know, a doctorate in that, and they'll sit there and go, yeah, so what if they're putting stuff in the food and water? There's too many people. And I look at them and I say, did you get a memo not to drink the fluoridated water, to not take the vaccines? And sometimes they'll look at you and go, yeah. I remember having the state attorney on 5 years ago. You remember the case? They were able to actually found the video of it from CNN and stuff in a Greater Good DVD film exposing vaccines. They actually dug it up, where they had thousands of kids in Maryland lined up at one courthouse crying with police dogs saying it's the law to take the shots. And they're like, I'm scared, I don't want to do it. And the parents were there. And I had the state attorney on, and he admitted he didn't vaccinate his kids, started laughing. I mean, these people are crazy, man. They're crazy. I mean, the God fear I've got, I don't have to ever go to a church to get it. Man, when I even think about somebody that is joking they don't give shots to their kids, but their color of law conning other kids to take it, I mean, and they think it's funny that they are leading people into destruction. Leading the little ones that suffer, the children, better to tie a millstone around your neck. I can feel God's wrath. I mean, that's what God fear is that you know what's right and you know what's wrong. You know what your conscience is? That's God fear. I don't fear those that can kill my body. I fear the great spirit that can cut me off. That's all hell is being cut off from God. And let me tell you, all you that are going to serve evil that think evil's powerful and pretty and you like it, you have no idea. You have no idea. I have seen into the minds of the evil. I have seen it, and it has irrevocably affected me. Just knowing it, the knowledge that I have researched and received, it's more than just researched it. And let me tell you, you have no idea the gulfs of black evil that you are descending into. This culture of death, this culture of evil, oh my God, and the innocent children are shooting up everywhere right now with hundreds and hundreds of shots by the time they're 10 years of age. And I go out to restaurants and places and you look at the kids, they're all look mentally retarded now. Or you can walk over, the kids all look healthy and have electricity in their eyes. Let me guess, you eat nothing but non-GMO and your kids have not been vaccinated. I actually do this. They'll go, yeah, Alex, we're listeners too. And I think of how they're robbing them. Oh, my God. And setting the precedent to just see what they can do to us. See how they can hurt us. See what they can do. And the average doctor is just a, you know, brainwashed person that won't admit that they've been wrong. And so they just go along with it. All right, look at this great evil. Then I'll go to some of your phone calls on 880 AM in Arkansas and other stations. A front group for the psychopharmacological industrial complex. Let me find the WorldNet Daily original article, because it's the same story, but now it's being implemented. This program got stopped by Congress. Bush signed an executive order back in 2004. See, I said 5 years ago. Time just flies. This is 8 years ago. No, six and a half years ago, 2004, Bush to screen population for mental illness. And one of their own insiders blew the whistle back in 04 out of Pennsylvania, the person on the national board, and they have all this in here, that Big Pharma wrote this up to go from 20% of the population, including kids on psychotropics, to 50% is the goal. and it got held back. Now, October 1st, or 8 days ago, it began implementation in the public schools. And it's written by Big Pharma to put your kids on these drugs. And then once, and again, when the state has you, 69% of foster kids are on an average of 7 psychotropics. And it gets so bad, the goal, they've had medical doctors go public in a WOAI investigation in San Antonio, that then the convulsions start, and then, and oh, that's even better. Now you put them on anti-convulsive medicine, and then they kill a lot of them with the drugs. I mean, the state will put a kid on so many drugs, it kills them. That's a soft kill victory. We have the head of the state psychiatry board in Endgame telling the state legislature, she's Susanna Hupp, at the Congress, the state rep woman. She says, well, why are more than two-thirds of the kids on psychotropics in Texas? They said, well, they come from bad gene pools. She's like, do you do any tests? No, they just come from bad gene pools. Woo, yeah, yeah. Well, you know what? You don't sign me on to hurting kids, okay? You can sign me off of that. And if you don't like it, you can kill me right now. I'm going to resist you with the InfoWar 110%. I'm glad you've signed on to your evil. I'm actually not glad, but those of you that consciously love the ultimate sin and know you're evil and you think you get power, I'm glad you're going to get what's coming to you, because I'm not worried about my body. And let me tell you something. You are going to get repaid a trillion times for what you do to children. I just hope you understand that. I hope you understand that. I hope you understand that. I hope you understand that. You think it's fun to hurt innocent people? You think it's fun to hurt little children? You think it's fun, all the horrible things, those thousands of paralyzed kids in India from just last year's attacks? You think that's fun, what you're doing to those little kids, paralyzed for life, those that lived? You think that's fun, ruining their hopes and dreams? Make me sick. Make me sick. Screening for mental disorders in children and adolescents. This is out now. And they're announcing how wonderful it is in the public schools and other schools, how all of this has started. That's a story from last year. Action Alert, mandatory health screening for children. That's Association of American Physicians and Surgeons. That's a group exposing it. We need to get them back on. That was a good guess when I had that doctor, the head of that, on. Where's the new one I had today? Here it is, October 6th, government-sponsored mind control in America, the teen screen scam. Yeah, death education, teaching kids how to commit suicide so they won't do it, has massively increased suicide. Where's my new article? I've got a new article out today on this. Health Aware, free depression screenings at Linden Oaks. Yeah, here's one of the hundreds of new articles. It can strain relationships, hurt your performance at work or school, and make you not want to get out of bed in the morning. Yeah, it's called television watching and GMOs. Yet depression often goes undiagnosed and untreated. Well, don't worry. If you have lack of motivation, if you have any stress, if you're upset, well, just call us and we'll get you hopped up. So that's going on in the public schools right now. When you put your child in a government training camp, and I know they've bankrupted everybody, so they have to, you're putting them in there to be victimized. So if you've got to stay in a government training camp, let's have a jailbreak. Educate and inform your children and give them information like our magazine that you can buy at cost to go and give to prisoners so they understand we can use the prison complex as a place to try to wake people up to the attack they're under. We'll be right back. All right, let's go to your phone calls. Turkey shells Syria for 6 days, says worst case scenario unfolding, threatening ground invasion. And through Turkey, they're bringing in tens of thousands of al-Qaeda. Obama's endorsing it. Romney's endorsing it. I mean, this is insane. Man, they just prey on the total ignorance of the public. It's just amazing. Bunch of other key articles up at Infowars.com as well. It's going to get so crazy. And they now... Secretary of Defense admits that there's a fight between Shiites and Sunnis starting a civil war. Well, that's what I told you months ago is the plan in the region. To get those people all to kill each other and then use it as a pretext to take our liberties. You know, that's what's even worse about this is they also then use it to take my freedoms and your freedoms. Wow. New congressional amendment prepares for mass casualties in America. That has not passed the House yet. I misread that yesterday. American undergraduates re- recruited for population control. TSA worker smacked me in my testicles for refusing body scan. I should have gotten to that. That is the most incredible article. Because watch, it has all these links to Congress people, Miss USA, you name it, where they're told you're going to be punished now. And then they crush your testicles. Or they rob your money and say it's for punishment. Or they say you can't fly and it's for punishment. And we have all the videos of them admitting it. I mean, it's just like they're torturing us now as a total joke because al-Qaeda might get us. And then meanwhile, the government runs al-Qaeda. It's just totally insane. That's all up at Infowars.com and Propoganda.com. Get that article out of the featured news out to everybody. Let's go to Frank in Arkansas, listening on 880 AM KLRG. Welcome to the airwave, sir.
How you doing, sir? I appreciate you. I wanted to just let you know that you woke me up, and I've just started listening to you recently in the last couple of months. I think you're doing a great job, and it's really hard to try to talk to people about all the stuff that's going on just because they don't seem to...
Same thing in Nazi Germany. Up until 45, most Germans did not know they were killing people in mass. It was rumors, and it's the same deal. When scientists went public, they were injecting black people with syphilis. No one believed it for 20 years until it was released. I mean, it's like no one ever wants to believe that bad things are happening. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, no, just that. I just, you know, the other thing I wanted to talk to you about was, you know, I drive a truck and I've noticed a lot of police vehicles and it says U.S. Federal Police Services on the side.
They now have federal police everywhere. Totally out of their jurisdiction, and TSA, who aren't even sworn officers, and they've got Homeland Command, Rural Council, which is run by the Pentagon, and says the plainclothes army are going to spy on rural communities. I mean, you can't make this up. It's a takeover.
I appreciate you, sir. I just want to say God bless. You're doing an awesome job.
No, God bless you. Again, ladies and gentlemen, it's worse than I can even say. Let's go ahead and talk to Richard in Arizona. You're on the air, Richard.
Alex, I know you're almost done here. I've got one important point I wanted to make. I've been a private health researcher and investigator since 1965, and I have not seen one piece of evidence indicating any kind of disease prevention from any kind of vaccination.
Well, yeah, I've had major scientists on worldwide. Hygiene and plumbing by the 20s and 30s is what reduced pathogenic spread. And then when vaccines became widespread by the 40s, you actually see an increase in infectious diseases previous the dip. I mean, is that what you're basically talking about?
I'm going back to the 1600s and looking at the beginning of when they were used in countries like Denmark and Germany and other ones. And, it was kind of just a crazy experiment in the beginning, and it wasn't the drug.
I'll tell you what, stay there. We're doing some overdrive. Yeah, that's Malthusian science, 280 years old. And the globalists are trying to manage our poisoning and death, and then they profit off of sucking all the money we've shaved out of us. They have actuaries all breaking it down. And that's what's going on. The average doctor, the average nurse, they're just brainwashed technicians, overworked. Picked because they'll follow orders, compartmentalized. But we were talking to Richard in Arizona, a healthcare researcher. Yeah, if you go back, 400 years or so with the first smallpox inoculations, which were just taking the pus out of cows and putting it on humans, if memory serves, and then from other humans to other humans. And we've got British manuals about how to give smallpox blankets to the Indians. I mean, bioweapons are an old system. We have the Huns catapulting plague-ridden black plague bodies over into the Qin cities or Chinese cities. You're definitely right about that. And what Malthus, 200-plus years ago, he said, cram people into compact cities, release plague on them to get rid of the scum. Tell us more about your research.
Well, basically, my research is in about, you know, the basics of how to actually get rid of disease without needing the medical system. But what I was talking about with the history of vaccination is that in the beginning, in the 1600s and 1700s and afterwards, when these experiments were done and vaccination was tried as an experiment in quite a few different countries, sometimes made forcible even back then, it always created plagues. of the same disease that it was supposed to.
You know, I've seen evidence of that over the years. I mean, look at the plagues they're causing in India right now with the oral polio vaccine. Guys, show me a document cam of this poor little girl here. This was, I mean, look at that little girl, and they're giving her the oral vaccine right there, just absolutely dastardly. And that's 47,000, but my numbers are 67,000 ended up getting a sterilized, a paralyzed, some of them dying from it. I mean, just think of the ultimate evil of that. You know what? You should, with your evidence, write an article and send it, and then we look over it if it has the evidence. We'd publish it at prisonplanet.com or infowars.com.
Sure. I would love to work with you any way I could, Alex.
Thank you, sir. I've seen some of that research over the years. I'm saying recodify it. Send it on over. Find that British, it's from like the 1750s, that British officer's manual talking about how to kill the natives with the, get it from men who freshly have the pox, then give it immediately to the savages to kill them. And stuff like that. People need to see all that in context, understand what's happening. I appreciate you joining us, calling us. And, so many listeners out there, this just sounds over the top. Well, history's over the top. Rick in California, last caller we have time for. You're on the air, got about a minute and a half.
Alex, it's an honor to talk to you. Since I got a short time, I'll just get to the most important thing. I'm a disabled veteran, and I just won a decade-long war for trying to get 100% disability from them that I was entitled to the whole time. And this message is for every veteran who's trying to get any benefit at all from the VA. The red tape that they're so fond of throwing in our way to try and block us from getting anything, they have red tape they have to jump through, too. And it's called Title 38 of the United States Code of Federal Regulations.
That's right. They always leave themselves back doors and escape hatches. They don't ever want you to know. This whole system is about they're exempt. But you see, the way law works, you can be exempt from all their evil, too, if you know the hatches.
Exactly. And if you take the time to sit there and read through there, it will tell you everything that they have to do on your behalf. And you print that out and you take that into there to them and you say, you go ahead and violate federal law to my face.
And they immediately know that you're aware of what's going on. And the mercenary foreign non-doctors, fraud doctors, then they back off and give you the care and move on to exterminating the next person. Unbelievable. We'll be right back with retransmission. Big show tonight, 7 o'clock, prisonplanet.tv.